Hi, my name is Robert Feranek, and today I would like to speak a little bit about Altium Vault. The word vault is used very often by Altium these days, and they always say it's a kind of data management, but be honest with you, I had no idea what it means, and I decided to spend one day with discovering features of the vault. And you don't need to spend this time because you can watch this video. Just give you an idea what is it all about. I go to my vault and I haven't tested all the features. I haven't tested the production release, the directories and this stuff. But what I was focusing on is mostly about libraries. And as you can see, I put there my schematic library, PCB library and component library. In one sentence, basically the vault is used to keep your revisions and status of components or schematic or some other stuff in one place. Revisions are quite clear. It's always when you make some changes and save it, you can then upload it to the vault as a different revision. The status is used, for example, to create a life cycle. It means in this case I use it on schematic symbol. When the symbol is created, it's new. When the symbol is checked by datasheet or comparing to the datasheet and we are sure the pins, numbers and pin names are correct, then it's checked, and when it's used on board, then it's marked as used. You can see who did these changes and when. Based on the status, we can see very easily what schematic symbols were checked and which are used and which has to be checked. It's same for PCB footprints and same for components. For components there is also one more advantage, as each component is built from a particular version of schematic symbol and particular version of PCB footprint. It means if you use a component in older schematic, it will always remember exact revision number of the component, and in case you change something, for example you update footprint a little bit, you make some changes and you use this component again in future, you know your old schematics will not be affected. What were the steps, what I actually done to test the vault is I went to my Altium account, then the main page, went here, downloaded this satellite vault and installed it on my computer or on my server. It's only one file, you just run the installation and there is no configuration, nothing. After the installation, go to preferences, vaults, add, find on LAN, it will find the computer. I already have it here, it's this one. There are only few settings what can be set. One is revision naming. It just says how the for example sheet symbol or board will be named. You can choose from more schemes or life cycle. This is actually the page where I set the status for the symbols and PCB footprints. New, checked, used in production. Once it is set, you need to go to your library and then say link to library. Set here the vault what you have, and here set the life cycle what we were just speaking about. For this component or for this schematic symbol, use the one what I created, and the revision naming, again component revision scheme, which I just call them 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, and that's it. Then link it to the vault. Now we need to release the schematic symbols to the vault. I already have them released, but when you do that first time and you analyze the document, all this will be enabled for release. There will be no state, there will be no current revision. You need to then prepare items and document and then release them. And that's it. Your schematic symbols will be then in your vault here, as I have them here. Now every time I make some changes in the schematic symbol, I will release it to the satellite vault, and the revision number will then change. Now how we can change the status of the component? We click and see the full details of the component. It will open in Altium, and here we can see this component or schematic symbol is new, it was just created. And for example, I just checked it based on datasheet and I want to mark it as checked. Then I press right click and mark it as checked. Once it is checked, I can then, for example, mark it as used in production. You may remember I set this life cycle, these steps, directly in this vault. These are the steps what I created. You can read the Altium help how to do it, but basically in each step you define what is the next step and what will be the text when you're asking to go to the next step. When I go back to my schematic library, then each symbol which is released in Vault has this small sign here, and when I click on it I can see the status of the schematic symbol and revision of the schematic symbol. It is same for PCB footprints. Basically you link library to Vault, you then release the library to the Vault, same steps as for schematic library, and then each symbol in the library has this small picture which says it is released in Vault, and again you see the status of the footprint and the revision of the footprint. Once we have the schematic symbol and footprint in our vault, we can then create a component. As I mentioned before, the component uses particular revision of symbol and particular revision of footprint. Creating a component library manually by pairing schematic symbol and PCB footprint would take a long time. There is a tool in Altium which can automatically generate the component library from your schematic library. Go here, select your schematic library, and use this migration tool, press OK, and this will generate the component library. This is the component library what I generated, and as you can see, it pairs PCB footprint with schematic symbol. Once we have the component library, we can release it into the vault. Go and select the component library and the path where you have it. Analyze the folder. And basically, again, when you select something, or when you do it first time, you have everything selected, and then you can release the selected components to the vault. Press release. If I press release now, it will change the revision number to 1.1. Once you have all the components in your vault, you can then use them in your schematic. As you can see, when I click on this component, it says it's from vault. You see the revision number and you see the status. When you click Show in Explorer, you see the component in the vault with all the information. In case you already have a schematic which doesn't use components from Vault, but it uses just standard components from your library, you can update them. Go to this item manager, and the item manager will list all the components in your schematic, and the components which are not from Vault, they will say they are unmanaged. I actually have all my components updated from Vault, then I can show this example, but when you see the unmanaged components, you just press this auto match unmanage button, and it will automatically update your schematic with components from the vault. I haven't tried all the options of the vault. For example, I didn't try linking sheet to vault or releasing board to the vault. But I hope this video gave you an idea what is it all about, and what are the possibilities and how the vault can be used in your company. I think it is definitely good solution for big companies and big development teams spread it around the world, and for companies which have some kind of procedures in development process. I hope you found this video useful and informative, and in case you have some questions or you would like to contact me, you can visit my blog, it's called Well Done Blog, and leave me there a message, or you can read there some posts and articles about Altium Designer or hardware design. Thank you very much.